Mercury is a fascinating material. Even I enjoy playing with it. But like most heavy metals, it is poisonous. It's quite surprising to people, if you have this liquid running around in a dish or something, how can it possibly poison you if you're not touching it? The answer is that there is vapor of mercury coming off, which you can breathe. And remarkably, it's quite easy to show you how this vapor comes off. Before we show you the experiment, I have to explain a little bit about mercury lamps. UV light can be generated by filling a tube with a small amount of mercury and then passing through an electric current. The electric current heats the mercury to very high temperature, and the mercury atoms give out ultraviolet light. This is light you can't see. And the ultraviolet light is at a very precise wavelength, around 254 nanometers. So now, Neil has one of these lamps, quite an old one, but it still works. And let's see what happens when he shines it across the surface of a dish of mercury. To make the effect a bit easier to film, he's warmed the mercury a bit, but it's not very warm, probably less than 100 degrees centigrade, like a cup of tea or something like that. We as humans cannot see UV light. Our eyes don't detect it. In order to see the output of the lamp, you have to shine it on a sheet of paper which contains a dye to make it look white. You know, paper is usually a bit brown. And that dye absorbs the UV light and gives out a sort of purplish colour of light. So that's why the piece of paper that Neil is holding is glowing purple. In between the lamp and the paper, there is vapour coming off the mercury. Not very much, but the mercury atoms in the vapour can absorb precisely the same wavelength of light as the lamp is giving out. So it acts as a very precise and powerful filter for the light. So the paper doesn't glow as brightly. And you can see these clouds of swirling vapour. And those clouds are the mercury vapour, which, if you had your nose close to it, you would be breathing in. And that's why liquid mercury is dangerous, because all the time vapour is coming off. And mercury is one of the elements which can accumulate in biological systems, like your body. So even if the mercury is coming off slowly, if you're exposed to it a long time, you can absorb quite a lot. And there's stories of old lab buildings where they used to use mercury, where when they're doing a refurbishment, they lift the floorboards and underneath there are pools of mercury, which have fallen through when people have spilt it over the years. In some of these places, there is quite a high level of mercury vapour that is coming up through the floor. That usually it's so dirty under the floor that there's a layer of dust which prevents most of it coming off. But the take-home message with this is that if you're using mercury, and there are all sorts of experiments where it's useful to use mercury, you must use it in a fume hood that's well ventilated so you don't breathe the vapour. From the vapour pressure in the air, and he dropped in the mercury. What's interesting is that as it goes into the liquid nitrogen, the nitrogen boils, and so the mercury falls, almost encased in a sort of bubble of nitrogen gas.